Hello, Ariel. My name is Guo Jing. I will report on my work. The title is New Results of Breaking the CLS Scheme from ACM-CCS 2014. First, I will introduce our contribution of this paper. There are mainly two aspects of work. One is to solve the search co-ACD problem, and the other is to perform ciphertext-only attacks on the CLS scheme. Compared with previous work, our attack only requires two samples for n equals p1 times p2, and when n is equals to the multiplication of n prime numbers, it also needs a smaller number of samples. Next, we present a ciphertext-only attack. This attack also needs a smaller number of samples, and there are no other set requirements for the plaintext. The outline of this report is divided into four parts. The first part introduces the relevant preliminary knowledge. The second part introduces the specific methods to solve the co-ACD problem. The third part introduces the ciphertext-only attack, and finally makes a summary. Let us first introduce the definition of the search co-ACD problem. Let nq each row be integers larger than 1, greater than 1. It is the length of pi, and the row is the length of arrow e. Co-ACD distribution is a set of e multiplies q mod pi. The search co-ACD problem is given arbitrarily many samples from the co-ACD distribution to recover pi. The following is a brief description of the CLS scheme. The key generation phase is to generate two prime numbers p1 and p2 as the primate key, as k, and generate parameters q and n. N is equal to p1 multiply p2. The encryption phase generates random row bit arrow e, and the output ciphertext c is the value of m plus eq mod p1 and p2 respectively. The decryption phase is to calculate m apostrophe by the Chinese remainder theorem, and then mod q, which is the message value m. Next, since the Coppersmith method is lattice-based, let us briefly introduce the lattice. Lemma 1 is the well-known LLL algorithm, where the norm of the first I vectors satisfy the following inequality. The last is about the Coppersmith method, which is a method used to solve the small root problem of modular polynomial equations, where the uppercase xi denotes the bound of the root. The Coppersmith method is divided into four main steps. The first step is to construct new modular polynomials g to ensure that they have the same root xi apostrophe as the original equation f at module t's power of p. The second step is to construct the lattice using the coefficients of the newly constructed polynomial g, which variables multiplied by the corresponding bounds xi. The third step is to perform the lattice reduction algorithm on the lattice to obtain the equation over integer field with the desired root. The fourth step is to solve the root by the resultant method or the Grobner-Basis technique. In this step, it is necessary to assume that these polynomials are linearly independent to ensure that there is a solution. Thus, the Coppersmith method is heuristic. In the process, the following lemma reformulated by Hargreaves is needed. It states that under which condition a modular equation holds over the integers. Combining lemma 1 and lemma 2, the condition of obtaining at least m polynomials with a common desired root xi over integer is this inequality. In the following section, we will describe the specific method to solve the co-ACD search problem. The result we get is when rho satisfies this condition and m is greater than or equal to n, we can solve the search co-ACD problem heuristically. We give experiment results when n equals to 2, which can successfully solve the problem with only two samples, that is less than previous work. I will introduce the complete method with n equals 2 and n equals 2 as an example to facilitate your understanding. Given two co-ACD samples, we can consider EJ as a small root and solve it using the Coppersmith method. Therefore, follow the steps mentioned earlier. The first step is to construct the modular polynomials with the same root. We construct two types of polynomials. In type 1, we multiply two equations together and obtain a new equation that the module pi are multiplied to n. Rearranging this equation, we can obtain a modular equation for E1. Let the coefficient of the squared term of E1 be 1, we can get a monic polynomial F1. Then, in type 2, by the Chinese remainder theory, we can get the new equations of the module n. Then combine them together to get a matrix equation. Construct a 2x2 matrix C with each vector coefficient. Then the equation can be rewritten as follows. Since P1 bar and plus P2 bar is congruent to 1 under module n, we want to put the vector pi bar on one side, so left multiplied in inverse of C. We assume that matrix C is invertible in modular ring Zn, otherwise a non-trivial factor of n can be easily obtained. Then we multiply an O1 vector on the left so that the sum of pi bar is calculated on the right as 1. We denote the known coefficients by B21 and B22. Then we can obtain the modular equation with two variables, E1 and E2. This gives us the second class modular polynomials, F2. We use F1 and F2, construct the set of polynomials G with the same roots to module the t-th power of n. Clearly, their roots are E1 and E2. The n part is to ensure that the equation mod the t-th power of n is 0. And the x1 part is to ensure that the constructed matrix is lower triangular. Next, construct a lattice LT with coefficients of GS1, S2. Because the construction of the lattice basis matrix is related to all monomials X1, S1, X2, S2, we define an order to make the matrix be lower triangular. The order of the monomials is to compare S2 and S2 apostrophe first. And if they are the same size, compare S1 and S1 apostrophe. It can be found in the full paper that mathematical induction proves the basis matrix is lower triangular. In the following, we calculate the conditions of the root bound. First, we analyze the dimension and the determinant of the lattice. The dimension of the lattice is the number of monomials. That is, all the possibilities that satisfy S1 and plus S2 greater than 0, less than t. Regarding the calculation of the determinant, since the basis matrix is lower triangular, we can just focus on the elements on the diagonal. Wn and wx for powers of n and x are the summation of powers in all cases. Then we substitute them into inequality in lemma 2 to obtain the bound of root x. Then replacing x by the root power of 2, we can get the result about solving the search co-ACD problem. When n is greater than 2, it is a similar approach, and the details can be found in the full article. In the next section, we present the ciphertext-only attack against the CLS scheme, but requires a known module n. The result is that we can recover private keys P1 and P2 as long as the number of ciphertexts M is greater than this value. We have also done experiments, and for these three parameter settings, three ciphertexts can successfully recover the private key. The method of attack is described below. There are four equations. Let xi equal mi plus eiq. Multiply this by this and this by this. They both hold for mod n. Eliminate the same variable x1 times x2 and normalize the coefficient of x2. We obtain the equations on x1 and x2 and then solve them using the lattice method. We can construct such a matrix where the diagonal n denotes the module and I in the first row are the coefficients of the equation. After some linear combinations of the row vectors in matrix B, we can obtain that vectors V1 and V2 are both short vectors in the lattice according to the parameter settings. Under a certain condition, as we will show later, the target vector V2 can be written as a linear combination of vectors B1 and B2, where B1 and B2 denote the first two vectors output by the LLL algorithm. The modular equation alpha B11 plus beta B21 mod P1 equals 0 according to the first element of the vector. Then we can use Coppersmith method to solve alpha and beta. Calculate the great common divisor of V21 and N, which is the prime number P1 we want. To meet the condition that V2 is equal to alpha beta 1 plus beta B2, we use the Gaussian heuristic and wanted the norm of V2 to be less than this value. The condition of the number of samples M is obtained. Finally, a few words about the problems and the prospects of this study. The tests we performed are based on the non-N, but the CLS scheme doesn't require a publican. Therefore, we would like to study how to complete the key recovery attack or solve the co-ACD problem when N is unknown. And when N greater than 2, how to conduct a ciphertext-only attack. That's all I have to report. Thank you.